Hi students, today we will discuss the position of any two circles in a plane. That is, if you take any two circles in a plane, what are the possibilities for those two circles? That is, when they touch each other externally, they touch each other internally, they will intersect, all those properties and some other properties related to those two circles we will discuss. Okay, we will start it now. First definition we will see, if you take any two circles, when those two circles are set to touch each other, I mean touch each other means they may touch each other externally or they may touch each other internally. Suppose if I take here it is one circle and other circle, if I take this one, yes, we will say these two circles are touching each other, of course externally, or these two circles may be like this also, then these two circles are said to touch each other internally. Now when we say that these two circles touch each other, two circles S equal to 0 and S dash is equal to 0, name of this circle notation, are set to touch each other if they have a unique point in common. Here you observe, this is only the point that is common to these two circles, then we can say that these two circles touch each other. Of course, even in this case also, it is only the common point for these two circles, then these two circles are said to touch each other. Of course, in this case, touch each other externally, in this case, touch each other internally. That is, observe this. Two circles S equal to 0 and S dash equal to 0 are said to touch each other if they have a unique point in common. And that common point is called point of contact of the circles. In this case, it is the point of contact. In this case, it is the point of contact. If you take any two circles, what are the possibilities you see? One circle may be completely outside the other, or these two circles may touch each other, or these two circles may intersect each other, or these two circles may touch each other internally, or one circle may be completely inside the other. And of course, one case you may get, they are concentric circles we have seen. Now, we will take any two circles S equal to 0 and S dash equal to 0 and let us find out what are the conditions that these two circles completely one outside the other, when they touch each other externally or intersect each other, or one lies completely inside the other, we will see all these cases. Now we will discuss all those properties one by one. Let us take S equal to 0 and S dash equal to 0 be two circles. Let centers of these circles, let C1 be the center of this circle and C2 be the center of this circle, and radii of these two circles, R1 be the radius of this circle, R2 be the radius of this circle we will take. Now let us see. Now these two circles, one completely outside the other, it is case 1. May touch externally. Intersect each other. Touch each other internally, and one circle may be completely inside the other. We will discuss one by one. Here C1 be the center of the circle and C2 be the center of the circle. And let us take distance between the centers of the circles denoted by D. That is C1, C2 equal to D. C1, C2 equal to D. Now, till here it is R1 and till here it is R2. It is radius of the second circle and it is radius of the first circle. Now, complete from here to here it is D. Now, let us establish a relation between R1, R2 and D. Observe this. If you take distance between the centers complete from here to here, and when you take radius this one and radius this one, we can say distance between the centers always greater than that of sum of radii. Sum of radii will give this distance plus this distance, whereas D, this part will be extra in that one. Therefore, we can write here D greater than sum of the radii of these two circles. So, whenever if you observe two circles where distance between the centers is greater than that sum of the radii, then we can say one circle lies completely outside the other. This is the condition for this. Second, you take here it is C1 and here it is C2 and now join that it is D and here it is R1 and here it is R2. You can easily observe here distance between centers D is nothing but this radius plus this radius. D is equal to R1 plus R2 you will get in this case. Therefore, whenever distance between the centers is equal to sum of their radii, then we can say circles touch each other externally. And next, we will observe this case first, touch each other. Now, it is C1 and it is C2 and if I take this is D and observe this, from year to year complete this value is R1 and from here to here this is R2, radius of the small circle. Now, if I subtract these two, I will get this one only, R1 minus R2, which is C1, C2. Therefore, whenever C1, C2 that is equal to D equal to R1 minus R2, then we can say one circle touches other circle internally. Sometimes R1 may be greater than R2, sometimes R2 may be greater than R1. Of course, here I have chosen R1 greater than, I wrote this one. In general, we can write D is equal to mod of R1 minus R2. It will be R1 minus R2 or R2 minus R1 depends on R1 greater than R2 or R2 greater than R1. Observe these two cases. Touch each other externally means distance between the centers equal to sum of the radii. Touch each other internally means distance between the centers is equal to difference of the radii. Now, you observe this case, it is C1 and it is C2 and this is what D. Look here carefully. And from this center to till here it is R1 and from center to till here it is R2. D is this, If I take addition R1 plus R2, this value is there, no, inside. This part will be added 2 times. Therefore, we can say R1 plus R2 is greater than that of distance between the centers. Therefore, clearly I can write D less than R1 plus R2. And if I take differences R1 minus R2, here it is R1 and here it is R2, I will write it is less than R1 minus R2, I can take modulus, because R2 may be greater than R1 or R1 may be greater than R2. Therefore, it is the condition when two circles intersect each other. If they intersect at two distinct points, then mod of R1 minus R2 is less than D is less than R1 plus R2. And in the last case, it is C1 and it is C2. Distance between the centers is D. And observe this. Complete from here to here, center to this one, it is R1 and this is R2. This radius R2, complete this radius R1. It is D. If I take D plus R2, what you will get, you observe? D is this distance, R2 is this. R1 means from here to here. Therefore, D plus R2, if you take, it is less than R1, because R1 will cover even this part also. Therefore, R1 is greater than that of distance between the centers plus this radius. Therefore, D plus R2 is less than R1, or that implies I can write D less than R1 minus R2. Hence, here also I can write, because we do not know R1 greater than R2 or R2 greater than R1, I will write D less than mod of R1 minus R2 is the case. Therefore, these are the all possible 5 cases, and you must remember all these cases, and any examination you take, either it may be descriptive, that is subjective, or objective examinations, definitely we can expect questions on these concepts, and many problems based on these concepts we are going to practice in our sessions. Therefore, once again, possibilities for any two circles, one may be completely outside the other, they may touch each other externally or internally, or they may intersect each other, or one circle may lie completely inside the other. One completely outside the other means a distance between the centers greater than that of sum of radii. Touch each other externally means a distance between the centers equal to sum of the radii. Touch each other internally means a distance between the centers is equal to modulus of difference of the radii. And intersect each other means definitely R1 plus R2 is greater than that of distance between the centers, and distance between the centers is greater than that of mod R1 minus R2. And if one lies completely inside the other, then D less than mod of R1 minus R2. Hope you understood this concept, and next we will move to the other concept. Now, we will see other concept, that is a common tangent. Already we have discussed when you take only one circle, when a line is said to be a tangent. When a line is said to be a tangent to the circle, if it touches at a unique point. Here also same kind definition. If I take any two circles S equal to 0 and S dash equal to 0, or any two circles if you take, a line L equal to 0 is said to be a common tangent if it touches both the circles. if it touches both the circles. Now, if I take s equal to 0 and s dash equal to 0, because it is a tangent to this circle as well as this circle, therefore, now this line L equal to 0 is said to be a common tangent to these two circles. Or if I take these two circles, here it is. Now, if I take a line which touches both the circles, now it is also said to be a common tangent. Now, common tangents are of two types. One is a direct common tangent, second one is transverse common tangent. Direct common tangent and transverse common tangent. When a common tangent is said to be a direct common tangent, and when a common tangent is said to be a transverse common tangent. Observe this. A common tangent is said to be a direct common tangent if the centers of both the circles lie on same side of the tangent. If I take these two circles, now if I take it is a tangent because these two centers lie on the same side of this tangent, therefore, this tangent is called a direct common tangent. And a common tangent is said to be a transverse common tangent if centers of the circles lie on opposite sides of that common tangent. Because if you take these two circles and it is a common tangent, since these centers lie on opposite sides of this line L equal to 0, therefore, it is a transverse common tangent. So, what is a common tangent? First, you see, a line L equal to 0 is said to be a common tangent to the circles S equal to 0 and S dash equal to 0, if that line L equal to touches both the circles. That common tangent is said to be a direct common tangent if the centers of both the circles lie on the same side of the tangent, and it is said to be transverse common tangent if centers of the circles lie on opposite side of that common tangent. It is what definition of common tangent and direct common tangent and transverse common tangent. And we will see, as we have discussed all five cases, how many common tangents are possible. Out of those common tangent, how many direct common tangents are there and how many transverse common tangents are there, we will see. We have seen all these cases. What are the possibilities if you take any two circles? One may be completely outside, or they may touch each other externally, or may they intersect each other, or they may touch each other internally, or one lies completely inside the other. We have seen all the conditions for distance between the centers and radii, and we will see how many common tangents are possible. Here you observe, for this circle, one tangent here, other tangent here, and next, yes, one tangent here and other tangent here. Total number of common tangents therefore in this total number of common tangents are 4 are possible. Out of these 4 common tangents, let us see how many direct common tangents are there, how many transverse common tangents are there, let us see. If you take this tangent and this tangent, for these two tangents, centers lie on the same side. Therefore, number of direct common tangents 2 and number of transverse common tangents also 2 are possible in this case. And take second case. Here, yes, it is one common tangent and it is another common tangent, and one more common tangent is possible here at point of contact. Therefore, total number of common tangents in this case are 3. Out of these 3, these 2 are direct common tangents, because both the centers lie on same side of this line and same side of this line. And how many transverse common tangent is there? Only one transverse common tangent is possible in this case. And next, if you take this one, where circles intersect each other, yes, here one tangent is possible and here one tangent is possible. Therefore, number of common tangents are 2 only, and both are direct common tangents only, and transverse common tangents not possible only in this case. And fourth case, if you say two circles touch each other internally, only one point common is there, and number of common tangents for this one, only one common tangent is possible. And because both the centers lie on the same side of this one, we can say there is only one direct common tangent and there is no transverse common tangent in that case. And if you take one circle lies completely inside the other, then there is no common tangent for this. Therefore, common tangents does not exist, no common tangent, and there is no direct common tangent, there is no transverse common tangent in this case. So, these are the cases, please observe. When one circle completely lies outside the other, total number of common tangents 4 are possible. Out of those 4, 2 are direct common tangents and 2 are transverse common tangents. 2 direct, 2 common, transverse. And when one circle touches other externally, then total number of common tangents 3. Out of these 3, 2 are direct and 1 is transverse. And if two circles intersect each other, then total number of common tangents are 2, and both are direct common tangents only, and there is no transverse common tangent. And if you take circles touch each other internally, there is only one common tangent, and that is direct common tangent only, there is no transverse common tangent in this case. And one completely lies inside the other, then there is no common tangent at all. There is no question of direct or common transverse common tangents. Hope you got this one. We have seen what is a common tangent, what is a direct common tangent, and what is a transverse common tangent. And now let us find lengths of those direct common tangent and transverse common tangent. First of all, what is the length of the direct common tangent and what is the length of transverse common tangent? One second, we will see. Suppose if I take any two circles, you know what is a direct common tangent here. If I draw a tangent, if it touches at A and B, means it is called a common tangent, and of course, it is a direct common tangent because both the centers of these circles are on same side of the line or same side of the tangent. Now, the distance between those points of contacts, that is AB, is called length of direct common tangent. A simple thing only it is. If you take A and B are the points of contacts of that common tangent, then distance AB is nothing but length of the direct common tangent. And if I take two circles here, and what is a common transverse common tangent, you see? Yes, it is the transverse common tangent. And if I take, these are the points of contacts, now this distance AB is called length of transverse common tangent. Now let us find these lengths AB, and here AB length of. Already we know, if you take one circle S equal to 0 and from any point, if a tangent is drawn, if it is P and a point of contact is A, then PA is called a length of the tangent. And we have seen length of the tangent from a point to a circle is root of S11. And here we will see What is AB? That is length of the direct common tangent and length of the transverse common tangent separately. Of course, these two results, length of direct common tangent and length of transverse common tangent, are very important results, and you need to remember these. Definitely will be helpful for any competitive exams. And let us derive it first. Simple results only. Here it is one circle, and here it is another circle. Let center of this circle you take it as C1, and center of this circle is equal to C2, and a common tangent I am taking. This is common tangent. Let it be A, and it is B. Now we need this length AB. That is what length of the common tangent. Direct, we will find that one. And it is a radius of first circle, we will take it is R1, and it is a radius of second circle, let us take it is R2. And we know because it is radius and tangent, this is perpendicular, and here also it is 90 degrees. And now, if I join these two centers, means we will get it is a distance between the centers only D. And now what I will do, you see. Observe this carefully. Passing through the center, a line which is parallel to AB, I will draw to cut this one at some point. Suppose it is the point where this line passing through C2 and parallel to AB, therefore here it is 90 degrees, and let it be it is some M. Now C2M is parallel to AB. Because this radius perpendicular to tangent, this line perpendicular to this, and what about this part C1M, you see. It is a total R1 and it is R2, means this is R2, this part is nothing but R1 minus R2. And now AB is nothing but MC2 only. This AB and MC2 both are equal only because it is a rectangle. And MC1, C2 is a right angle triangle. In this right angle triangle, C1, C2 is the hypotenuse. Therefore, I will write C1, C2 whole square is equal to C1M whole square plus MC2 whole square. I want MC2 only. Therefore, MC2 whole square is equal to C1, C2 whole square minus C1M whole square. It is equal to d square minus c1m, means r1 minus r2, it is r1 minus r2 whole square. Therefore, mc2, mc2 is nothing but ab, ab is equal to root over d square minus of r1 minus r2 whole square. Therefore, length of direct common tangent for two circles whose radii are R1, R2, and D is the distance between the centers, if you take, it is equal to root over D square minus of R1 minus R2 whole square. Second case, length of transverse common tangent. Here let me take one circle and let it be the other circle. A transverse common tangent I will take. Yes, it is the transverse common tangent. Let it be the center C1 and this be the center C2. And if I join them, means a distance between the centers D, C1, C2 is equal. Let this point of contact I will take A. This point of contact I will take B. Now I need AB length. Because it is a tangent and it is radius, therefore these two are perpendicular, and of course these two are also perpendicular. Now what I will do, you see. Parallel to AB, I will draw a line passing through the centers, I mean center of the second circle. Yes, it is a line parallel to AB and passing through C2, and I will produce this to intersect at some point here. Because it is perpendicular to this tangent, therefore it is perpendicular to this line which is parallel to this. Therefore, here it is 90 degrees. Now, what is C1A radius of the first circle R1 I will take, and C2B radius of the second circle R2. It is R2 means this is also R2 only, therefore total this distance is R1 plus R2. Observe the simple geometry only we are applying. Now, C1 MC2 is a right angle triangle, complete this big triangle, where it is the hypotenuse. Therefore, C1 C2 whole square is equal to C1 M whole square plus MC2 whole square. What is C1 C2? It is a D only. D square equal to C1 M. R1 plus R2 whole square plus MC2. MC2 is nothing but AB only, that AB square. Therefore, AB square is equal to D square minus of R1 plus R2 whole square, or AB is equal to root over D square minus of R1 plus R2 whole square. Therefore, it is the length of transverse common tangent AB. Hence, length of direct common tangent square root of D square minus of R1 minus R2 whole square, transverse common tangent length square root of D square minus of R1 plus R2 whole square. This is the method how you can find that length. Now, we will see other point, centers of similitudes. What are these centers of similitudes? If I take any two circles S equal to 0 and S dash equal to 0, you know what is a direct common tangent and what is a transverse common tangent. It is a direct common tangent and it is a direct common tangent. If they intersect this point of intersection, that is the point of intersection of direct common tangents is called external center of similitude. The point of intersection of direct common tangents, if it exists, is called external center of similitude. And if you take transverse common tangents, that is here if I take it is one common tangent, and here if you take it is another common tangent, and now intersection of these two is called internal center of similitude. That is the point of intersection of transverse common tangents is called internal center of similitude, and point of intersection of direct common tangents is called external center of similitude. How to find these centers of similitudes we will see. First make a note of this point. If S equal to 0 and S dash equal to 0 be two circles, then the point of intersection of direct common tangents is called external center of similitude, and the point of intersection of transverse common tangents is called internal center of similitude. Now we will see how to find these centers of similitudes. S equal to 0, S dash equal to 0, we are taking two circles with centers at C1 comma C2 and their radii are R1 comma R2. And if you take A1 and A2 are respectively the internal and external centers of similitudes of these two circles, then A1 divides line joining of the centers in the ratio R1:R2 internally. A1 means internal center of similitude, and A2 divides, that is external center of similitude divides C1 C2 in the ratio R1:R2 externally. We will see it. Observe. Here one circle S equal to 0 and here other circle S dash equal to 0 we will take. It is S equal to 0 and it is S prime equal to 0. and let it be center of the first circle C1 and let it be center of the second circle C2. And we will take one transverse common tangent here and other transverse common tangent this one. Let it be, it is P, it is Q, and let it be, it is R and it is S. Because it is intersection of these transverse common tangents, we have taken it as A1 in the statement. And now line joining of these two centers, if I take, this is line joining of the centers. Now observe this. If I join this C1P, because it is radius and it is tangent here 90 degrees. Similarly, if I join this, because it is radius and it is tangent here 90 degrees. And see this carefully. In these triangles C1P A1, C2Q A1, these angles are same, and here it is 90 degrees, therefore this angle also same only. Implies we can write C1P A1 and C2Q A1 are similar triangles. Because these two triangles are similar, we can take ratio of their sides. That implies we can take C1P by C2Q is equal to C1A1 by C2A1. What is C1P? It is radius of first circle C1. What is C2Q? It is radius of second circle. Therefore, R1 by R2 is equal to C1A1 by C2A1 implies C1A1 is to C2A1 is equal to R1 is to R2. What is the meaning here? C1A1 is to C2A2 equal to R1 is to R2 means this A1 divides line joining of the centers C1 and C2 in the ratio R1 is to R2 internally. A simple result only. We have taken one transverse common tangent and we observed that these two triangles C1P A1 and C2Q A1 are similar triangles. Therefore, ratio of their corresponding side, that is C1P by C2Q is equal to C1A1 by C2A1. Hence, from that we can say A1 divides C1 C2 in the ratio R1 is to R2 internally. That is A1 divides C1 C2 in the ratio R1 is to R2 internally. Similarly, we can establish that relation that external center of similitude means point of intersection of direct common tangents will divide line joining of these centers in the ratio R1 is to R2 externally. You can observe that. Here one circle I have taken, other circle I have taken. I will take direct common tangent. Here also direct common tangent I will take. Let it be, it is A2 and centers it is C1 and it is C2. Line joining centers and join this one also. You can take this is perpendicular and you can take this is perpendicular. And let it be, it is P and it is Q. Now clearly you can observe the triangles C1P A2 and C2Q A2. Therefore, if you take ratio of the sides here, you will get, because A2 lies outside of the line joining the centers, we can say that divides C1 C2 in the ratio R1 is to R2 externally. So, here what you need to remember, point of intersection of transverse common tangents is internal center of similitude and it divides line joining of centers in the ratio R1 is to R2 internally. And point of intersection of direct common tangents is external center of similitude, and this external center of similitude A2 divides C1 C2 in the ratio R1 is to R2 externally. These points you must remember. Okay, based on the theory points what we have covered, we will see some problems on this. First, what a statement is? Verify whether the following circles touch each other externally or internally, or intersecting at two points, or one is completely inside the other. Yes, the first concept we have discussed. Distance between the centers, and if you find radii and find relations and check what type of circles are they. Let us see first problem. C1 center of the circle, if I take 2 comma minus 1, radius r1 equal to 3. C2 center of the circle, it is minus 1 comma 3 and radius is equal to 2u. You know, it is standard form, x minus alpha whole square plus y minus beta whole square equal to r square. Find the distance between the centers, C1 into C2, it is square root of 2 plus 1, 9, 3 plus 1 whole square, 16 is equal to 5. And of course, r1 plus r2 equal to, you can observe, it is 3 plus 2 is equal to 5. Therefore, if I take d, d is equal to r1 plus r2. Yes, completed. When d is equal to r1 plus r2 means we can say both the circles touch each other externally. Therefore, these two circles in the first problem touch each other externally. Second one. What is center of first circle C1 if you take for this one? It is minus 3 comma minus 3. And R1 if I take root of 9 plus 9 minus 14, it is equal to 2. Minus 3 comma minus 3 is the center, radius 9 plus 9 minus 14, 18 minus 14, root 4 is equal to 2. And second circle center if I take C2, 1 comma 2. Radius r2, it is root of 1 plus 4 is equal to 3. Now, we will see distance between the center C1, C2 is equal to root of 1 plus 3, 4 square, 16 plus 2 plus 3, 5 square, 25, it is equal to root 41. Therefore, d is equal to C1, C2 is equal to root of 16 plus 25 equal to root 41. Observe that. This value greater than 6, and sum of the radii if you take it is 5 only, I can write r1 plus r2 is equal to 5 only, therefore d is greater than r1 plus r2. D greater than r1 plus r2 means we can write circles completely, one lies outside the other, therefore one lies outside the other. One lies the outside the other. This is what. Third one. What is center of first circle? You see, C1 is equal to 1 comma minus 2. R1 is equal to root of 1 plus 4 is equal to 3. And C2 is equal to minus 2 comma 3. And R2 is equal to root of 4 plus 9 plus 3, it is 4, 16, root 16 equal to 4. What is C1, C2? You see, C1, C2, distance between the centers is equal to square root of 1 plus 2 whole square 9, 3 plus 2 whole square 25, 25 means root 34. This root 34 means it is less than 6 and greater than 5. Observe this. Here definitely C1, C2 means it is equal to D root of 34, and R1 plus R2 if I take it is 3 plus 4 equal to 7. Therefore, D less than R1 plus R2. R1 plus R2 is 7, 7 greater than that of root 34. Of course, it is easily you can observe less than mod of R1 minus R2. What is R1 minus R2? One only. R1 minus R2 is equal to modulus, if you take it is 1, that is 1 less than root 34 is less than R1 plus R2, means it is equal to 7. Hence, circles must intersect at two distinct points. Therefore, we can say in this case, intersecting circles, observe. Why here third case? Distance between the centers root 34, it is not equal to sum, not equal to difference. Therefore, I am checking with sum of the radii, 3 plus 4 is equal to 7, that R1 plus R2 greater than that of this. Therefore, D less than R1 plus R2. And if you see mod of R1 minus R2 means it is 1, obviously it is 1 less than D less than R1 plus R2. That is mod R1 minus R2 less than D less than R1 plus R2. It is the case where both the circles intersect each other. Yes, other problem, almost similar to previous one. Find the number of common tangents that can be drawn for the following circles. First, let us handle first circle. To check how many tangents, common tangents that can be drawn to two circles means, we must know position of the circles. Means either one lies completely outside the other, or touch each other internally or externally, or intersecting, or one lies other, then only we can decide how many number of common tangents that can be drawn to those two circles. Now, first circle, if I take center C1, 2 comma minus 1, R1, it is square root of 4 plus 1 plus 4, it is equal to 3. Center of second circle is minus 1 comma 3, radius R2, root of 1 plus 9 minus 6 is equal to 2. Now, find the distance between the centers. C1 into C2 is equal to square root of 2 plus 1. 3 square 9 plus 16, 4 square is equal to 5. And R1 plus R2, if you observe directly, 5. Therefore, distance between the centers is equal to sum of the radii. Hence, we can say one circle touches other circle externally. It is the condition when two circles, one touches other externally. Because these two circles touch each other externally, how many common tangents are possible? Three common tangents are possible. Therefore, number of common tangents, how many are there? It is equal to 3. And of course, out of those common tangents, we know two direct common tangents are there and one transverse common tangent is there. That they are not asking, of course, you can distinguish. And let us see second problem. Here, what is center of the first circle? C1 minus 2 comma 3, R1 root over 4 plus 9 plus 3. It is equal to 4. It is C1 and R1. Let us find C2 and R2. What is center of second circle? Minus 2 comma 1. Radius of second circle? 4 plus 1 minus 4 equal to 1. Now, distance between the centers is equal to square root of 0 plus 4. It is equal to 2. Therefore, distance between the centers. Hence, we observe here, D equal to 2, R1 equal to 4, R2 equal to 1. Observe, difference between the radii, if you take, it is equal to 3, that is greater than that of distance between the centers. That is mod of R1 minus R2, if you take it is equal to 2, it is greater than that of distance between the center. That is D less than mod of R1 minus R2. D less than mod of R1 minus R2 means one circle lies completely inside. It is the condition for this. Hence, one circle completely lies inside the other means there is no common tangents. Hence, number of common tangents. Number of common tangents to these two circles is equal to 0. You have right, other problem. If the circles x square plus y square plus 2ax plus c equal to 0, x square plus y square plus 2by plus c equal to 0 touch each other, then show that 1 by a square plus 1 by b square equal to 1 by c. Here they have given touch each other means may touch each other externally or they may touch each other internally. What is center of the first circle C1? Minus a comma 0. And what is the radius of this one? Root of a square minus c. Center of second circle C2? 0 comma minus b. And radius of second circle? Root of b square minus c. Observe this. If it is the case, then we know D equal to R1 plus R2. And if it is the case, we know D is equal to mod of R1 minus R2. But here they have given touch each other. We do not know either externally or internally. Hence, we can write D is equal to R1 plus R minus R2, we can take. What is D here? Square root of distance between these two centers only, a square plus b square is equal to root over a square minus c plus r minus root over b square minus c modulus. Squaring on both sides, a square plus b square equal to a square minus c plus b square minus c, either plus you take or minus you take, plus r minus 2 into root over a square minus c into root over b square minus c. Hope you have followed this step. I am squaring it on both sides. Root of a square plus b square whole square is equal to square of this plus r minus 2ab. Now, a square plus b square will get cancelled here. Minus c, if I bring this side, 2c is equal to plus r minus 2 into root over a square minus c into b square minus c, I can write. This 2 also will get cancelled. Again, square it on both sides. C square equal to multiplication a square b square minus a square c minus b square c plus c square. Again, this c square will get cancelled. Now, this relation is a square b square equal to, if I take c common and take that side, c into a square plus b square. I want in that form, that implies I can write 1 by c is equal to a square plus b square by a square b square, or 1 by c is equal to 1 by a square plus 1 by b square is the relation that we need. Yes. Here this problem, find the internal center of similitude of the circles. Yes. Find centers of these circles, C1 equal to minus 3 comma 1 and C2 is equal to 1 comma 3. And what is R1? You see, square root of 9 plus 1 minus 1 is equal to 3. And R2 is equal to square root of 1 plus 9 minus 9 is equal to 1. Yes, these are the circles. And of course, directly they are asking find internal center of similitude of the circles means definitely the transverse common tangents must exist and that point of intersection of transverse common tangents they are asking. We know that internal center of similitude divides line joining centers in the ratio R1:R2 internally. What are the centers here? -3, 1 and 1, 3. R1:R2 means 3:1 internal. By using section formula, 3 × 1 + 1 × -3 / 3 + 1, 3 × 3 + 1 × 1 / 3 + 1. It is equal to 0, 10/4, that is 5/2. It is the internal center of similitude. Center of first circle is 1, 3. Radius of this circle is square root of 1 + 9 - 9 = 1. And center of second circle is 0, 0. Radius of that circle is 2. Therefore, now how exactly these two are, you see? It is R2. If we observe circles, distance between the centers, if I take d equal to root of 1 + 9 is equal to root 10. Obviously, it is greater than 1 + 2. Therefore, d greater than R1 + R2 means circles, one circle completely outside of the other. Here it is the other circle. And point of intersection of these direct common tangents will be external center of similitude. And we know that divides line joining of these centers in the ratio R1:R2 externally. What is this big circle center, you see? 0, 0. And small circle center, it is 1, 3. Radius of this circle is 2. Radius of the circle is 1. Therefore, now 0, 0, 1, 3 in the ratio 2:1 externally. Now, use section formula 2 × 1, 2 - 1 × 0 / 2 - 1. 2 × 3, 6 - 1 × 0 / 2 - 1 is equal to 2, 6 is the external center of similitude for these two circles. Today we have seen the concepts of two circles, whether one lies completely outside the other, they touch each other externally or internally, or intersecting, or one lies completely inside the other. And next we have seen what is a direct common tangent, what is transverse common tangent, and how to find lengths of those common tangents. And of course, we have not seen a problem on that. And next, what are the centers of similitudes, that is external center of similitude and internal center of similitude, and problems related to them, some problems we did. I think many concepts we have completed, and examples related to them we have done. And tomorrow, we will see completely problems based on these concepts and also the concepts which we have covered earlier. Till then, take care and all the best.